Hey folks, welcome back to some more Mary Skelter 2. On our last episode, we had managed to return to the Libri District. However, everything was not quite intact, as it was set aflame and people we had cared about were slaughtered by a nightmare. And also, a bunch of our Blood Maidens went into hiding. So, with that wee tidbit in mind, let us continue henceforth with this dream sequence. But also, before we continue, like, full on forward, what's this gonna be about? We'll be caught if we head back now. Okay, so yeah, we are quite literally running away. But hey, it's best to double check. But also, one other thing I'd like to mention is I actually had to get back to this point because, incidentally, when I stopped recording, the game crashed shortly afterwards, and wait, are we already out? What's this about? An event? That was awfully short. Bail, baby boy! Assuming you're the nightmare I assume you to be. Finally got away from those people. Then again, there's also the possibility of it being that nightmare that ended up, well, killing everybody at our base. I can finally rest. Is this place... Amazing. After all that searching, finally. Well, there wasn't much searching going on. I just kind of went straight in a line. I kind of feel like as if I missed out on that front. It's been a while since I saw people, but no one was in there. Oh, this must be Jack then. Oh, yep, indeed was. Okie dokes. Wakey wakey, sleepyheads. It's kind of odd seeing a nightmare having a nightmare, though. Nightmareception. Good morning to you too, baby boy.
Jack も夢見るんだな。びっくりしたよ。
I'm glad I was with him. After all, I'm able to share his thoughts and feelings.
決していい夢ではなかったかもしれないけど。いつかいい夢が見られるといいな、ジャック。
Oh, I hope so.
それにしてもジャック、ようやくこの日が来たな。ついに今日から景色少女の捜索開始だ。遅刻したらみんなに何言われるか。
Yeah, more of them might have went berserk during our absence.
ジャック、今ちょっと手が離せない。って。
Oh, is it time to skedaddle? Oh my! Woo!
Just wait a minute, Jack. This sarashi is a bit difficult.
Holy moly, are you packing on the chest area, Otsu? Dang! I thought her size was pretty good as is, but turns out she was a lot more, well endowed. Oh my! I mean, this is fine. Indeed. I'm not surprised! Yeah, you gotta keep up your masculinity for a mermaid.
Yosh, できた。どうだい、ジャック?
As sharp as ever, my prince. Oh, so it was a time skip, huh?
で、どうだったみんな。ここを拠点にするって言ってはみたけど、住むには難しいかな。
敵がいないって意味ではいい場所だが、居住のために作られた施設でもない。住むにはいろいろ足りねえだろうな。
Well, that does make sense, since for the longest time it did kind of only house one person, and that one person probably didn't even think they were human for a while.
じゃあ最悪、ここは寝床だけにして、必要なものはまた解放地区に探しに行くしかないか。
Oh, that's a good idea. Just salvage what's usable and rebuild from there.
お前の意見はどうなんだ、いつき。ざっと見た感じだが、なんとか拠点にできると思う。
本当か？
ノイス。
まあ、かなりの大改造が必要な点は否めないがな。主に寝床を作るという意味で。
最低限必要な電気と水道は生きてたから、ちょっと修理すれば使えるようになるよ。
修理できるのか？
拙者に任せておくがいい。
お、匠もついに輝く時が来たか。
Hey, look, he was trying before.
輝いてるよ。僕ちんいつだって輝きっぱなしだよ。
You're shining in my heart of heights, boy.
わかってるって。頼りにしてるからね、匠。それに楓もいつきも。
姫、よかったな。これで希望がさらに見えてきた。
そうだね、おつーちゃん。
姫。
それで、さっきも言ったように、住居を作るのが最も大変だと思う。
つまりは力仕事だな。任せとけ。俺と匠でどうにかする。
Oh, hey, so you do have a use. I'm sorry I had to take the jab.
Eh? Ataimo?
Chikara shigoto ni muite sou na no wa ore tachi kurai shika inei daro.
Also, wait, Takumi has muscles? Hang on, I need to double check on this front. Kinda hard to tell.
Atai wa infra no seibi ga aru shi, hoka o tayotte hoshii na nante.
Oh, like maybe Hamelin? I mean, she was pretty strong.
なこと言ったの他に誰が？
お、貴様ら探したぞ。
Yeah, speaking of the devil.
お、いた。
なんだお前たち、我の顔をジロジロ見て。
ハーメルン、お前確かすっごい力持ちだったよな。
その通り、力には自信があるぞ。
よしよし、労働力確保だ。
守るこんなちっちゃな女の子を肉体労働に借り出すの？ひどいな。
Is it really, considering the fact that she could have just manhandled us had we not been able to convince her?
見てくれは小さくても、こいつには俺たちじゃ比べ物にならないくらいの力がある。
Yeah, looks can be deceiving.
光だって見ただろう。あの鬼ごっこの時に。ハーメルも使わない手はないぜ。
なんか知らんが、手伝えることなら手伝ってやるぞ。
Aw, thank you, Cadley.
助かるぜ、ハーメル。後でよろしくね。
ハメちゃんが頑張ってくれてる間に。電気と水道はバッチリ直しとくぜ。
うむ、その電気とやらがあれば漫画をもっと明るい場所で読めるのだな。
Oh, but of course.
大事なのそこかよ。
Well, yeah.
まあまあいいじゃない、ハーメルンちゃんには大事なことなんだよ。
インフラ整備の件はこれでいいとして、体制が整った後はどうする？
当面の目的は生き延びること、それから他の結色少女を探す。
どっちも長丁場になりそうだな。
覚悟はしてる。そのためにここに拠点を作るんだから。
長く共同生活を送るためにも各々役割を決めておいた方がいいね。
I mean, yeah, that's a point. So, what's Otsu gonna do then? Murmy, I can get about the gist of things, like some kind of medical team, but maybe Otsu could patrol?
また全員でゾロゾロ探索しに行くってのも、あまり効率的とは言えないしな。
Oh, about the Blood Maiden, Sphaerdos.
僕と姫、それにジャックは、景色少女たちの捜索でいいかな。
もちろん我も同行するぞ。この力必要であろう。
それはありがたいけど、ここの安全は。
お前らがいない間は俺が警備を引き受ける。
Hopefully we don't get a repeat of what happened last time。
ついでにこの辺の探索もやっておく。生き残った連中が迷い込んでくるかもしれないしな。
Because, I mean, we had somebody guarding the area before, and Blood Maiden said, well, yeah.
大丈夫なのか？そんなに一人で抱え込んで。
なこと言われなくても分かってるって。探索っつっても、門番と警備のついでに、その辺を見て回るだけだ。やばいと思ったらとっとと逃げるさ。それに、お前らはメルヘンどもがうよいよいるとこに行くことになるんだ。戦力は少しでも多い方がいいだろう。
そうか。僕たちがいない間は、守るにかなり負担をかけてしまうな。
気にすんなっての。もともとこういう方が性に合ってるんだ。
心配なら、我の下僕を残しておくぞ。
Oh, yeah, do that, please!
だそうだ。
うん、心強いよ。
じゃあ、ワイは、そんなおつーちゃんたちの武器の改良やな。
Oh, that used to be Haru's job!
黎明で学んだ景色武器の改良技術。見たらきっと惚れてまうで。死の者言わんと、ワイに任せとき。
Don't worry, I already am!
僕はこれまでの経験を生かして、ジェイルと景色少女の研究でいいかな。
博士の意思を継いでってところだね。
ああ、そんなところだ。きっと有用な情報を君たち景色少女に提供しよう。
私は生活用品から探索に役立つもの、いろいろな道具の配給と整理をやるよ。
ああ、なんか整列させるのうまそうだよな。
分かってるじゃん。そうだよ、ちゃんと並ばないやつはいつだって蹴っ飛ばしてやるからね。
あ、じゃあ私はどうしようかな。水汲みとか。
Yeah, you could go draw some water.
そんなん俺がやるっつの。お前は救護室とかだろ。
Oh, fair dose.
え？私、簡単な手当てくらいしかできないよ。
I mean, somebody's gotta do it.
それができるだけでも、ここではありがたいってこと。必要な物資は後で届けるから。
そうだな、ヒカリ。適材適所だ。君が救護室にいてくれればみんな救われると思う。
わかった。みんながいいなら私頑張るね。皆さん本当にありがとうございます。
礼なんか言うなって。助け合いなんて仲間なら当たり前だ。
最後にこの拠点の名前を発表するのだ。
Oh, is it gonna be as grandiose as yourself?
おお、一応聞いておいてやるよ。
I mean, besides, we may as well give Hamelin the privilege. She did offer us her, well, a board after all.
いいか、貴様ら、聞いて驚け。その名も
It's just the same thing as before, but with your name tagged on. Gosh, dang
it! Where do I put it? What do I do to
release it? Yeah, that too.
Well,
if Hamelin was released to the world, it would be close.
That's a stretch.
解放地区って言いたかっただけだろうが。
そんなことはないぞ。
Oh, sorry again.
あ、図星なんだ。すっごい噛んじゃってるし、ハーメルンちゃん。全然噛んでにゃい。
まあ、ハーメルンの住まいを間借りしてるし、名前はそれでいいか。
気に入ったのなら素直に言えばよいもの。まあよい。ではハーメルン解放地区で決定だな。
And that's that.
ハーメルン解放地区、ね、まあ言い慣れるとこれはこれでしっくりきてしまうのが恐ろしい。
I mean, in all fairness, it's very similar to what our old base of operations was named. It's just you tacked on Hamelin. Next thing you know, we'll get Hamelin bathwater, Hamelin rations. You know, we gotta spread the brand.
Yosh, 着替え完了。お待たせ、ジャック。ああ。今日から本格的に創作開始だ。一緒に頑張ろうな。さて、人魚姫は大丈夫かな。いろいろありすぎて最近ふさぎがちだったし。
Well, you see, she did kind of bear witness to a bunch of people she cared about die in various horrific manners.
ちゃんと僕がそばにいてあげないとな。
But of course.
みんな、すまない。遅くなった。
これで全員揃ったな。では、始めようか。さて、今日から早速、景色少女の創作になるわけだが。
うん。まずは、元解放地区から近い、水族館跡エリアって話だったよね。
Oh, that sounds like new territory.
そこは未知の場所だったりするのか。
I haven't either.
昔探索したことあるよ。でもこうなってしまった今は安全とは言い難いだろうね。
Okay, well, I guess I'm the only one included in that front then. Fine.
ああ、だから探索チームは決して無理をしないでほしい。
僕たちが倒れたらもう景色少女を再結集させられなくなるからね。気をつけるよ。
そうじゃないよ、おつーちゃん。そのことも大事だけど、何よりみんな無事で帰ってきてほしいだけ。
ああ、これ以上仲間が傷つくのはもう見たくないんだ。
それでも君たちに託すしかないのは本当に申し訳ないのだけど。
そっか、ごめん。心配してくれてありがとう、みんな。ちゃんと無事で帰ってくるよ。
あ、信じてるよ。
それで、探すっていう景色少女は何人いるんだ？
僕と姫を除いて、黎明にはあと6人いたよ。
And then there was also Alice. Granted, she wasn't a part of Dawn. As a present.
まずは赤ずきん、マモルたちの解放に行った時に一緒に行動してたんだ。でもあの時の混乱で離れ離れになっちゃってね。
遠目に見ただけだけど全員すげえ強かったからきっと大丈夫だって。
うん、絶対大丈夫だよ。
うん、ありがとう。それとこれも同じく一緒に行動していたアリス。チャック、あ、分かってるよ。この通り、アリスはジャックの大切な人だ。だから必ず見つけ出してあげたい。
Oh, don't worry, she's very important to me too. And I'm genuinely curious as to how she's been faring.
俺らも長いことお隣さんだったからな。人事とは思えねえよ。
うん、もう家族みたいなものだよね。
そして次がかぐや姫。彼女は黎明に残っていた。
Oh my gosh, that just sounds like her. She's still as lazy as ever.
そして親指姫、白雪姫、眠り姫の3姉妹で6人だ。まあ親指姫たち3姉妹は協力してくれるかわからないけどね。
なんかあったのか？
ちょっとね。とにかく最善は尽くすよ。
そうしてくれると信じてるよ。それで水族館アトエリアには潜伏できそうな場所ってのはあるのか？
潜伏できそうな場所って言われると難しいけどね。でも元解放地区から近い水族館アトエリアは逃げ込むのに最適とも言えるから、もしかしたら誰かいるかもしれない。
こっち側に誰も逃げてきてないなら唯一行ける水族館アートエリアは期待できそうだね。
よっしゃ、作戦が決まると希望が出てくるな。
And just something to go on.
じゃあ準備ができ次第僕たちは出発するよ。大丈夫かい姫。
Yeah, how are you faring? Ah, not as talkative, huh?
みんな頑張ってるし、私も負けてられないね。
姫、何か抱えてるなら僕に相談をしてくれ。
ううん、本当に大丈夫だよ。何も心配いらないよ。
そうか、それならいいんだけど。
It's hard to see her faking such an obvious front like that. Little Mermaid can be a bit stubborn at times, but...
いつだって僕は姫の味方だからね。それだけは忘れないでほしい。
Oh! We finally got Rabbit Hole, huh? That's gonna be really useful. But righty-ho, let's read this out.Nightmare Jack uses Rabbit Hole. This creates a save point and an escape route out of the dungeon. You can only set save points in certain areas, so create save points as you find them. Note that setting a new Rabbit Hole will erase any previous Rabbit Hole that was set. So now we don't need to look around for save points, we can just set one whenever we need to. But right, so let's go to the base headquarters.Actually, wait a moment. Oh! So the Hamelin Liberty District's name didn't stick, huh? Aw, I'm kinda disappointed. But well, as the new Liberty District, after all. Right, living quarters. Let's just check out all of the attractions at our base. You can give surprise items to any of the Blood Maidens in their rooms. There are two types of surprise items.Gifts and interior items. Raise the Blood Maiden's affection by giving them items. You may get items in return too. The level of affection can trigger various events, open new skills, and can affect the story too. Interior items change a Blood Maiden's room decor. Interior items can be freely changed at any time. Coolio! Right, so I doubt we have any events judging by the screen right now. But let's just check our affection. Just a Volkeek. Okay, so Mermy has 4 affection out of 5, I presume, and well, Hamlin has none. Actually, does this change if we do that? Okay, so we get some brief voice lines, albeit no subtitles to match, though. Oh well. Right, so Mermy's room. Oh, it's nice to see that the rooms still have their own themes. I really like that. So we've got a bit of an aquatic theme for Mermy. Oh, I wonder what Hamlin's is going to be like now. I see a bunch of swords embedded in the ground. Oh, she's probably one of a heroic theme this time. I see. I like that new touch, though. Coolio! Right, so time to go to the laboratory. I presume this is where we're going to do things like job changes and what have you. Yes. Okay, well, I don't think we have any job unlocked, right? But we may have some jobs that we can still check out nonetheless. But anyhoodles, use job unlock rights and blood crystals to change a Blood Maiden's job. Aw, man, they spoiled what one of them looked like. Regardless of that, though, that Milky Way class actually looks hecka dapper. Oh my gosh, I love the top hat and monocle. Oh, Otsu. But right, when you change jobs, you retain the same level, but stats change according to the job chosen. Various skills are available to each job and can be viewed via skill creation. You gain job unlock rights each time you raise the Blood Maiden's level to a certain point. Once a job is unlocked, you can freely change jobs at any time. Right, so judging by the fact that we had some DLC installed, we should have some jobs that we can swap to without job unlock rights. Oh, we actually get a preview of the skills before we unlock them. So, this was advertised as the caster class for Otsu, so let's just have a double check. It's got healing skills too, some stasis ailments, and moral force! Oh, but it has the chant prefix, so that probably means that it's going to take another turn to activate. Ah, oh, dang! That would have been hecka fun to abuse with the double turns shenanigans that Otsu can do. No, I didn't mean to do that. We need to check some more of the skills, just have a brief peek. Okay, well, we're not going to check out all the skills that these jobs can get, because chances are we are going to eventually try out most, if not all of these, at some point or another. Especially considering that it looks like Otsu is very versatile. Yeah, so she has essentially a class for any kind of role, huh? That's cool, though. Oh, she gets attack and skill block. And she has a class that's purely passive skills? Interesting, so that might be like an end-all be-all thing to go for. Anyway, let's check out some of these other jobs that we have, because these do not require any rights. Oh, I have a feeling what kind of attire this is going to be. Yo, it is Arata! Oh my gosh! I was just trying to... I just assumed it would be, based on the silhouette. Oh wow. You rock it, girl. But right. Let's have a look at the Blood Maiden swimsuit. Yo, she has shades? Nice! And a racy black bikini to go with it. But right. Back to Altair, though. Because while we could maybe use these jobs if we want to change things up a bit, I kind of want to hold off of them for now, especially things like the swimsuit, because it may take me out of the story a little bit. Especially when, you know, tension may rise. Of course, the Deafen attire may be a bit appropriate though, but that kind of changes our stats drastically. I mean, it completely changes Otsu's role in battle. Right. No. I'm not going to be tempted by the shades. I almost subconsciously changed to it. But right, so definite attire for you. Yo, Sheena. Okay, that's adorable. Although it has her name on it instead of Sheena's. It's got Ningyo. That's a cute touch. But right. And then blood mane and swimsuit. Oh, some seashells. That's a cute touch. Right, back to the therapist, because we can't become a magician. Because she starts off as a therapist. But right. Hamelin. Oh, is that Al? And it comes with ears and a tail. Okay, I like that quite a bit. It's a shame that it seems to be just a caster-oriented class, though. Yeah, it does. Oh, Al using Lunamisimo just would make sense to me. But it could be a way to get some caster skills in certain classes, though. But right, blood mane swimsuit. Now, is this a swimsuit or is this just her underwear from her original attire from when we first met her? You decide. Because, I mean, it's not like Hamelin was wearing much underneath her shawl to begin with. But hey, you do you. Right, so that's the laboratory. We can expand skill slots. Is there going to be a tutorial about this? Yes, there is. Use blood crystals to increase the number of skill slots and expand skill slots. Once you expand your skill slots, select set skills from the menu to confirm. We don't really need this right now, though. Since we don't really have much skills to begin with. And we may as well get Hamelin though. You know, let's give them all to 5. Just on the off chance. Right, blood packs. This is something completely new. Blood packs are used to learn blood pack skills. Blood pack appraisal. It's used to appraise and determine the content of blood packs. Use blood pack transfusion to learn skills. Used blood packs are lost during the process. Up to 99 blood packs can be transfused. The more used, the stronger the skill effect. You can gain blood packs through blood farming and blood flowers. Interesting, but we did also get quite a few from much as exploring the dungeon. I may as well appraise all of these, as I did get a decent sum of gold from just exploring the dungeon a bit. Right, so we've got HP heal, SP absorb, no ailment, war blood, and darkness blood. I have no clue what any of these are going to do, so I guess we'll try it out? Right, so I'm going to just assume that SP absorb is, well, as advertised, right? I don't know what that is going to entail, though. Because does that only apply to SP absorption skills, or is it... Or does that allow us to have the ability to absorb SP? I have no clue. But I know one thing's for sure. Put this on Mermy, since even if it is an additive, well, it just increases our healing potency. Water blots. We do use water skills on her quite frequently, but... Who knows later down the line. Then again, we could probably change them up, right? At least I hope so. And then no elements would probably be just physical skills. Well, since Hamelin is a fighter... Yep, it has no elemental attack. Good. And then body evolution is just lower their levels to get stronger, right? Yep. You can lure a Blood Maiden's level with de-evolution rites and blood crystals. Select the preset amount of levels to devolve when executing blood de-evolution. Depending on the chosen amount to devolve, you gain CP and stat bonuses. I actually abused this a decent amount in the prior title, but that was mainly just to try and make myself not too over-leveled at times. Granted, the bonuses did help, and it did also help for reallocating my CP. But any hoodles, by executing Blood De-Evolution, you can level a Blood Maiden again with boosted stats. you gain the evolution rights each time you raise the Blood Maiden's level to a certain point. Now, there are going to be benefits to doing this, especially with quite a few of the characters, but Otsu seemingly takes the longest to level up out of the batch from what I've noticed, because we've had Otsu and Mermi with each other almost in the entire time, right? But Otsu takes significantly more experience to level up, probably given the fact that she's also got Jack attached to her, and her unique trait of being able to take two turns a well turn. And she's probably not going to be interchangeable either, so she's just pretty much making up for what Jack originally did in Mary Skiller Nightmares. AKA an XP sponge, but right, Blood Weapon Factory. You can strengthen gear at the Blood Weapon Factory by using blood crystals gained in Bao. Your gear could be strengthened 20 times. We'll look at that a bit later. Because all it's just going to be is increased stats, huh? Alright, General Store. This might be pretty important. And no tutorial. I mean, that makes sense. It's self-explanatory. You just buy and sell items, you know, the works. Wait. DLC? Oh. This kind of stuff, huh? I mean, I may use this at times to maybe speed up grinding, but I don't think I'm gonna really abuse it right now. Because I just want to see how smooth the difficulty curve will be on Fear regardless. Because holy moly, the stats on these are significantly better than anything that I've got right now. Of course, these will eventually fall off and you'd only use them for, well, their secondary effects, but what happens when I do this? Is it just the one? Okay, it's just the one. Oh, it gives you a badge. Oh. I see. I was just like, oh, maybe get just one. Interesting. I'm not going to use these at the moment, though. I didn't mean to use one of them. I actually didn't end up reading it. So that was my bad. But anyways, I think this shall be our ending point for now. We did browse through a batch of tutorials and just learned a few new systems and what have you. But we could always set on out to, well, the dungeon next time. So, folks, thank you all for watching this episode of Mary Skelter 2, and I'll see you all next time. Ta-ta for now. Thank you.